this is a very exciting case study for us because we're going to feature two different businesses in the insurance industry who are both using Facebook advertising to generate leads, but in a very, very different way and to very, very different audiences with very, very different products. It shows how even when you're in the same industry, insurance, how different your approaches need to be based on your target audience and your irresistible offer. So without further ado, I wanted to welcome Allison McLaney of DigiPraise, who will then be followed by Michelle Rupp of NRG Insurance. Allison.
Thank you. I'm going to take over the screen share. Michelle, you're muted.
Sorry about that. That's a typical thing. Okay, so I'm Michelle Rupp with NRG Insurance. It's so fun to follow Allison because the minute I heard about her product, I'm like, oh girl, we are all over this. This is such a wonderful product for people. So, but in the meantime, I'll move on to us. I'm with NRG Insurance. This was such a great, a really, really wonderful journey for us. So the foundation of our business was really about my dad saying I'm second generation, that this business was a vehicle for all of us to have a better life, our clients, our employees, and to have a joyful life with a lot of security and safety. So these slides kind of represent, there's my mom and dad, and my mom is here somewhere in the audience, quite a bit older, but I think she's aged very well, frankly. We have a lot of fun. We do a lot of volunteer things. We use our little NRG car to go to children's festivals, et cetera. It represents the fact that we really, really work on our craft. We really want to know what's going on always in our business. So what we decided to do is to target tattoo studios. We'd already been working with these studios because one of our insurance companies had given us a list of leads. So I thought, well, let's just use this. And our persona is Mike and Mackenzie. They have a couple of kids. And if you guys notice, there's tattoo studios now everywhere. And actually, there was an article in the paper yesterday that tattoos are really happening after COVID. It's so interesting. So we targeted the state of Washington, 32 to 55, small business owners, tattoo artists. And I decided that our free irresistible offer would be a white paper around three items that most studios haven't thought about and ways they're exposed, because we want our personas to really care about their business and about insurance. So we did lead gen. We first did an awareness ad and then we did lead gen. One of my things is always you learn by your mistakes, and I had some technical glitches and went ahead and filed the first ad, or went ahead and posted it. And then Ricardo, who is my coach, pointed out that we were probably violating Facebook standards by using a little boobalicious ad. So the second ad I learned from my mistakes and covered her up a little bit more. But our call to action was through Facebook. And so I thought that the awareness ad in particular, when people would come and see that, because people in the studio, in the tattoo business, are obviously interested in tattoos. But I said in this slide, they came for the smut and they actually stayed for the insurance piece. So our playthroughs were actually pretty amazing, I thought. And I should have updated this slide, but we received two more leads this week, which is amazing. And had kind of an old school kind of a combo hybrid old school digital idea. When somebody showed a client, our now client, a picture of the ad, they held up their phone and he saw it and called us. So, and he has four studios. So we're in the process of closing that and we're working with two more accounts. So this is just really fun. I had no idea we'd have these kind of results. My biggest learnings were to experiment. And that is so fun because, you know, this whole idea, I can't tell you how many times I said, this isn't the time to be perfect. This is the time to get it done. So thank you, Dan, for that. Just in general, that's a life lesson for me. I really want to keep planning the customer journey in B2B for us, we have a very long lead time, so don't stop before the miracle happens. Also remember that you want to speak to your persona, but you also have your own brand to worry about. That was something. Thank you, Ricardo, for that. Our next step is to get super clear about who we are, just because that was fun to revisit after all these years. I want to do email campaigns. I want to really work on the customer journey and do a lot of more data analysis about how much our ad spend can be. And we're going to be calling on Ricardo to help us. So thank you, Dan. This was lovely. And I love our cohort. This was an amazing journey for me.